in the world of martial arts, the Philippines owns 5 world titles.
For a headbutt, low blow, back of the head and spine. I want a clean, fair fight. 5 rounds, touch bro if you want.
End last time point. They met, September 2014. It was a second round guillotine choke by Moraes over Eustaquio. 4 years ready? Later, how will times have changed? We are ready for the unification bout. Brought to you by Studio City, Asia's entertainment capital. Michael Schiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. Moraes has the length, has the height. Eustaquio's striking has improved out of sight in recent times. But how does the memory linger of being choked out 4 years ago in the second round? Eustaquio, though, has never lost a rematch, Mitch.
You know, and he's just gotten better and better every single time he steps into the cage, or the ring in this case. He says he's looking forward to being in the ring. He wants to utilize the ring's just dimensions and really start to confuse Moraes on the feet.
Moraes moving well early on, high on the balls of his feet. There's a high lift roundhouse kick from the Brazilian. Eustaquio, Wushu competitor. Multiple Wushu champion, over 30 Wushu wins. Let's see if that striking comes into play. Moraes, 4-time BJJ state champion, BJJ black belt under Ataedi Jr. His 11th appearance here in one championship, 8-2 in the promotion for the champ. Just feeling out process, outside leg kick Eustaquio, dipping body shot from Moraes. Moraes also wins over Karad Akhmatov, Eugene Takiro, Rico Shibuya, Danny Kingan. Eustaquio goes for the inside lead fly. Eustaquio has also beaten Akhmatov, Bunrad, Gianni Silva, Saiful Mirican, Alex Silva. Never been stopped by strikes. Geje Eustaquio. He's got a phenomenal gas tank as well. He did say he'll try and draw Moraes into deep water. Believes he'll decision Adriano Moraes tonight.
Nice little lead roundhouse there from Eustaquio.
A glorified kickboxing contest so far. Makes some feints here from the champion, switching stance, Adriano Moraes.
Look at Eustaquio going for the takedown, but caught in the arm there of the choke master.
Doesn't want to be there. He was there 4 years ago. A guillotine choke attempt from Moraes.
It's kind of tough to finish with one arm, if not pretty much impossible. But look at Eustaquio trying to work his way around the side, past the guard there of Moraes.
Don't grab the shoulder, don't grab the shoulder.
Look at Moraes consistently adjusting like a boa constrictor. Finding the perfect angle for that choke to get in.
Not where Eustaquio wants to be against the champion this early in the contest. Tight close guard here, but Eustaquio gives Olivier Costa the thumbs up.
You can see Moraes is starting to adjust. He's inching forward. Geje's got to plant his head into the ground and protect the neck. Then he starts the hand fight. He's got to start going after those hands to break that grip.
Moraes, is he expending his own energy and looking for the submission for so long, Mitch?
Man, when you've been doing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu as long as Adriano Moraes has, it's going to take a lot more than a 2-minute guillotine attempt to gas out your arms.
Is this dangerous for Eustaquio? How much of this guillotine? Oh, he's going to pop the head up. That answers that question. But he's still stuck inside the closed guard here.
Now, Olivier Boss is going to slide him around.
All right, ready? Chop.
What does Geje need to do here, Mitch?
Well, you might want to start posturing up and just start letting go of little short strikes. Drop the elbow, get back in, avoid, you know, any possible submission attempt from Marias. It's going to be tough for Geje to start passing the guard and the side control and mount. Maybe not tough, but it's going to be hard without dropping a lot of punches and doing some damage to Marias. Marias is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt and very skilled on the ground.
30 seconds left. Both guards still here from Marias. Geje would love to posture up and work some of those high fist strikes, get the ground and pound happening. Little popping punches, there's a nice elbow. Armbar!
Geje's got to stack him. He's got to be careful. He can't let Marias start to extend the body.
He's trying to pound his way out of this predicament and is out of there, Eustaquio! Balancing back, tries to reach into the canvas, the high knee! The high knee! What a way to end the opening round!
Look at that.
He flooded him up with the high knee!
Look at Geje bringing it to Macau. Sends the champion back to his stool with a bloody nose. Actually, they're both champions, but look at Geje going after the takedown, not scared of the ground game of Marias, doing a little bit of damage there. Marias was attempting the armbar, but Geje stacked him and dropped elbows to get his way out of it. Ooh, good round, good round.
Fantastic round. Marias in control for most of it. The final flurry from Geje Eustaquio damaging the world champion. What are you telling Geje to do in the second round, Mitch?
I like what he was doing before. He was very patient and calm on his feet. You can hear the crowd starting to get a little bit anxious, but Geje was very relaxed on his feet. I like what he was doing to the guard. Not scared to take Marias down, to put him on his back, showing he is legit on the ground.
Second round set for five. They bound out of their respective corners. Both men trade punches early on.
Eyes on Geje, just moving slightly out of the way with that head. His eyes are so quick.
Fakes and feints again from Marias, the larger of the two here. Eustaquio resets. Jab, no right hand for company, though, from Adriano Marias.
Marias has got to touch him with something. Throw that inside leg kick, you know, start putting out that jab. There's a right hand. That touched Geje.
Eustaquio also needs to capitalize while this contest is on the feet, Nick. On paper, Geje would have the striking advantage over Marias, but on the ground, it's Marias' world.
But Geje's a high-level striker, and he kind of takes time to get used to people's rhythm and their distance. So all you can see him doing is just sort of figuring out Marias. He does want to keep it on his feet, but he's figuring out exactly the distance and the timing of Marias so that he can start landing strikes later in the match.
How do you see the difference in Geje now to what it was 4 years ago when they first met?
Immensely, just to see the confidence of Geje to put Marias on his back, not be scared of the guard, completely relaxed to give the referee a thumbs up inside the choke, just to let him know that he's okay. That just goes to show you the mindset of Geje.
Marias coming forward, had some damage done by a high knee late in the first round, shoots it for a takedown. Well defended by Eustaquio. There's one of those great improvements.
Very good stuff of the takedown from Geje.
How about Adriano Marias? What changes from 4 years ago, Mitch?
Well, at this point, the match was almost over. So Marias ended it in the second round with a choke. But now we're seeing, we want to see a little bit more of a feeling out process for, you know, we're still seeing that feeling out process for Marias. Marias needs to put a little bit of heat on him. Utilize the angle, start putting pressure on Marias, on Geje. Start landing that big right hand, throw some low kicks.
Big left hook there from Geje Eustaquio. Now he's starting to load up the heavy artillery. Thought about going to the body. Goes up to the jaw of Marias. He's giving him a taste of the punch, giving him a taste of the kicks. Almost defense again from Geje Eustaquio.
Good job, but he's got the leg sucked in. Now he's transitioning to a single leg. Let's see if Marias elevates him, elevates that leg, goes after the body. Good chain wrestling. Now he's got the back.
Now into back here from Marias. The crowd, the passionate Filipinos in their thousands behind Geje Eustaquio.
Look for Geje to explode and spin. He's going to try to separate the grip a little bit. You can see him pushing on the hands there. Marias got one hook in, so he's got a little bit of security. See how he's grapevine that leg right there?
For Olivia Costa on top of the action. No takedowns successful for Marias here in the second round thus far.
Now Marias transitions to the other leg to get that hook in. Geje's doing a good job of defending by trying to put his back up against the ring post, but Marias goes airborne, try to lock in that second hook here. It's a bad spot for Geje.
In the corner, Adriana Marias, second round 4 years ago. It's where it ended with the guillotine chop.
Did you see that? He jumped off the ring rope to catapult himself onto the back, and now he's got body triangle. It's a bad spot for Geje.
A very bad spot. The body triangle is going to restrict the breathing of Geje Eustaquio, make it hard to get a full lung of air.
But he's almost got, he's on the side now. Geje may be able to spin, but he's got such a tight squeeze on that body triangle. Very hard for Geje to do anything.
Eustaquio gets out of the second round. It's third than he's ever been with Marias. Marias gonna try to choke him.
Arms cutting under. Jehe's gotta protect that neck. He's gotta hold those arms, make sure nothing gets through. But good job of Marias by softening up Geje.
20 seconds remaining. Can Marias find a choke? Geje defend it. Gives a thumbs up to referee Olivia Costa again. We are going to see the next round here. Marias will not finish Eustaquio. And they'll start from a striking position in the next stanza. What a contest. Wherever you're watching, around the world in 138 countries. We hope you're loving One Championship Pinnacle of Power live from Studio City, sold out in Macau, China.
Interesting exchanges so far. Geje was doing a little bit of damage on his feet there. The round was his until Marias was able to backpack. Geje utilized that body triangle, grapevine that leg, drop a little bit of ground and pound. Now they're not going to give him a near submission on that, but that is definitely ground control. Even though it's not on the ground.
I look very relaxed. I got the same edge in the Team Lakay corner.
They're just oozing confidence. They just, you can see second that in every out, single one of them. They're improving so much second in every out, area.
Now, third round of five in this World Championship main event in Macau, China. The champ, Adriana Marias. The interim champ, Geje Eustaquio.
Now Marias needs to kind of dictate this match on the feet. Right now he's got to start putting out that jab, utilizing those low kicks.
Nice
just
jab
like that.
Two. Off the bell from the champ, and another jab too. Goes to the body. Nice change of levels.
Geje, oh, nice counter there. Goes right up to the hook. Marias putting out that jab still. At least put something in Jehe's face. And the leg kicks.
A kickboxing contest again here in the third round. Both men trade jabs. Looping body shot off the lead hand there from Eustaquio.
Is
and a jab from the Filipino.
Is the momentum starting to shift to Marias' favor?
I don't see it so far, but Geje said he would increase the pace as the rounds go on. I want to see that happen from Eustaquio.
Geje looked annoyed almost at the attempt at a spinning back fist.
Outside leg kick, a nice one from the Wushu stylist. Eustaquio's got to get a move on in the striking. That is where he should be dominating Marias. Feel he's holding back a little too much though, Mitch.
Now he's got that single leg. Now Marias, good job by Geje to get him back up to a standing clinch. Marias spin him around, look for him to change levels.
Taking turns on being put against the ropes here. 3:30 remains in the third of five.
But as long as Jehe has those arms underneath, it's hard for Goliath to drop down and change levels.
Jehe looking for the elbows on the inside, good uppercut off the right hand from the Filipino. This is more like it from Eustaquio. Offering his head, hoping to sucker Marias in. Playing baiting games with the Brazilian. Is Jehe Eustaquio, high knee! From the Muay Thai clinch from Marias.
Just barely missed. Good takedown defense from the Filipino.
The crowd here, the heavy Filipino crowd in Macau, appreciating it. Jehe looking through his brow. Marias shoots him for a takedown. Jehe not going down on this occasion.
You can see the stance of Jehe is a little bit lower than usual, like his hands are down by his waist for just that reason. He can stop the takedown by reaching his arm, his hands under the arms of Marias. But Marias is able to get a takedown on this occasion.
Top position for Adrian and Marias. Not where Jehe Eustaquio wants to be. And Marias pass and go to side control, looks to get there. Roll through from Eustaquio, gives up his back. This could be dangerous, Mitch.
Good scramble by Jehe, but in that roll, he does give up his back and allows Marias to get one hook in. Marias is nice and tight to the back. Look for him to take that right arm and try to shove it under the chin of Jehe.
Jehe is going to have to defend the choke here.
Good scramble by Jehe.
Defend he does, Eustaquio, but what can he do off his back here? This is Marias' territory.
You can see him posted on that hip, trying to prevent Marias from moving forward and advancing his position, and he's able to get back into full guard.
Opens up the guard, throws the legs up, bends an elbow. Good work there from Eustaquio, keeping busy off his back. Closes the guard again, does the Filipino. 1 minute five remains, third round of five. Eustaquio, having gone further than he did against Marias 4 years ago, where he was subbed out in the second round, glances to his corner for some instruction. Does Jehe Eustaquio? What's up on the head? What's Marias looking to do here, Mitch?
He's trying to step over the guard of Jehe, so he's trying to like control posture, drop a little bit of ground and pound, and then he tries to see how he's trying to swing his left leg over. He's trying to step over the guard of Jehe and work to advance his position. But Jehe's doing a very good job of keeping his guard in place, but Marias is able to get past. Now he's in half guard. 27 seconds left to work.
Jehe hoping for the up kicks, gets them off now. That one to the midsection of Marias. Oh, Marias plows through with a straight right hand to the nose. That had some power behind
it.
This crowd screaming every time he's stuck where it lands, even off his back, and we're going into the fourth. Your thoughts so far, Mitch?
Very good round for Marias. He was able to close the distance, pressure Jehe up against the cage, and continually attack with the takedowns. There he is, landing a big right hand. Here he goes. Jehe had the underhooks, but Marias just picks him up and throws him onto his back. Here's that big right hand, how he was just able to cut through the guard and drop a big bomb on Jehe. Now, that championship experience of Marias is starting to show. He's starting to turn up the volume on some of these shots, and now we're entering the championship rounds. This is where champions are made.
Second outlines.
How do you see the evolutionary path of Eustaquio in handling the grappling of Marias? Because on the ground, Marias has been dominant.
It's every single one of Team Lakay's improved on the ground. And I am actually very impressed with Jehe's guard. He's able to maintain his guard in a lot of these positions with his legs wrapped around Marias. Marias before was cutting through his guard like a hot knife through butter. And now Jehe is able to maintain that guard, and really stop a lot of the damage from happening.
Mitch, you were in Baguio City a couple of months ago. You saw Jehe training firsthand.
man, these guys train so hard with so much intensity, and they all train at altitude. So you can almost feel your lungs start to collapse up there, and these guys are just used to it. That's why they get better and better with each round. But look at the champion. Looks just as fresh as he was in the first round.
Eustaquio needs to start applying the pressure, and he's striking. Cannot afford for Moraes to dictate the pace on the feet and to dictate on the ground. Oh, the high kick. Snap the taste out of his mouth. Outside leg kick misses the target for the Brazilian.
See, this is the stance that Geje normally employs. His hands are very close to his chin, and he keeps his guard up. And he's dropping his hands in a lower guard stance to prevent the takedowns from happening.
Moraes has Eustaquio on his back again. Butterfly hook from Eustaquio. Moraes looking to pass.
See, good job by Geje to recover back to full guard. You can see, like, when Geje puts his feet on the hips of Moraes, Moraes kind of flops down. That's so Geje slips the foot off of the hip, and so he can step over and advance his position.
Back to his feet here, tries to plow through the guard with that right hand as he did in the previous round. Adriano Moraes, the champion on top. Well, both champions, but the true champion, Moraes, the interim champion on his back, Geje Eustaquio. A unification bout here. Where does Geje go from here? What will the corner be telling him, Mitch?
Right now, he's just trying to control the posture, so Moraes is not able to posture up, create a little bit of space, and start landing shots.
And there's a shot as he postured up and created that space from Moraes.
Typically, the rule of thumb is that when you're in a defensive position, you need to create space on your opponent so you can get away. And usually the opposite is true when you're trying to attack, is you want to eliminate that space and crush your opponent.
2 minutes 20 remaining, fourth round of five. Looks to pass the guard. Eustaquio stuffs that attempt, though.
It's pass one. Now he's trying to use that other leg to step through. Good job by Geje, staying half guard.
Defensively doing well on the ground, Geje Eustaquio, but he needs some offense. He needs to start putting down some points.
See, look at that. He spin around. Now he's attacking the leg. Good job by Geje after getting dominated on the ground.
And he takes down Moraes. It's deafening in here.
And the crowd erupts.
Eustaquio, that's going to do wonders for his confidence. Here he comes now with the boxing jab, two. Throws the jab again to Filipino. Has he got his second win now? Can he start to establish his authority in the striking? Deafening chance for Eustaquio inside Studio City. Minute five now. A seesawing battle. There's a question mark kick. A Brazilian kick from the Brazilian. Outside lead kick from Eustaquio.
This is a very close round. So far, it's a lot of back and forth action from both guys. I'd like to see Eustaquio put a little bit of heat on Moraes. Same thing with Moraes. I'd like to see him start advancing the position. Olivia Cost might call for action soon.
What about a low level single leg there? Eustaquio. That's the left hand, not connecting for him. Jumping knee, Moraes looks for a counter, left to Eustaquio. Some much better signs from Geje in this fourth round. Defends the takedown, sprawls out back to his feet, almost took a knee to the jaw. Jumping knee again from Moraes, wants a takedown, gets it. Final seconds, they're gonna go into the fifth.
Nice little exclamation point on that round from Moraes. Geje did everything he could, but the jumping knee to the takedown was enough to score at that end of the round. You can see Geje catching one on the chin there. Marias, beautiful, done through the straight right hand, went in for the outside trip, lacing the leg, drab Eustaquio to the ground. Here's Geje going after a takedown of his own, sends Marias for a ride and putting him on his back.
All right, Mitch, where do we stand so far? One round remaining. We score an overall bout. Who is in control? Who's leading the way?
In my unofficial opinion, I have got to give, if the match was stopped right now, a slight edge to the champion, Adriano Marias.
Fifth.
Just controlling the ground positions a little bit more.
The old saying goes, Mitch, you've got to do more to arrest the title from the champion.
They both got titles.
The true champion. Okay, can Geje Eustaquio become the unified champion, or will Marias retain the title? 5 minutes remaining. And a chance go up for Eustaquio to get a driving takedown attempt here from Marias. Gets him down, goes to side control. An aggressive start from the champ.
Marias doesn't want to do any more of the stand-up. He immediately shoots in for a double leg and gets it. But look at Geje!
Oh, guillotine! Guillotine! Can he find the finish now?
Oh, he's starting to extend the body. Look at his body. He's extending it out. That's tough. That's close. Geje's got to fight it off. Oh, he does it!
He pops the head out like a jack in the box. And here comes the ground and pound for the Filipino.
Uh-oh.
It's crazy here in Macau, China.
Look at him. He's on top. Geje is going to drop a little bit of ground and pound.
Absolute pandemonium every time Geje Eustaquio gets on top or lands a blow.
Marias' corner almost jumped into the ring there in excitement. But good job by Geje to tough out the choke and remain on top in the last 3 minutes and 30 seconds.
Let's see what Geje can do on top of the BJJ multi-champion, of the one championship world champion. Marias trying to get back to his feet. Geje wants to keep him down. Pushes him like a wheelbarrow. Tries to keep him in the red corner. That leads him back now standing. Is this enough from Geje Eustaquio, Mitch? What a round from the Filipino here in the fifth.
At this, it's not enough. But if he can continue this roll right now, do a little bit of knees. Oh, look at Adriano Marias rolling for a leg lock.
As he locked it on, is Geje in trouble here?
He's got the leg crossed over the body, so Geje can actually attack here as well. It's kind of a 50-50 position. Let's see if Geje gets a knee bar here on the black belt.
The
Marias.
The biggest shock result would be if Geje submits Marias.
I have to agree with that one. But right now, Marias is the one on top. Look at Geje battling to get back to his feet. But Marias stops him from getting back up.
Inside the closed guard. We're past the halfway point to this final round. And what a cracking round it's been for Geje Eustaquio of the Philippines. He's got the Brazilian inside his guard, the closed guard. Trying to posture up, trying to land the ground and pound the last. Geje just escaped the knee. This crowd screams and shrieks for the Filipino. Finally again from Marias. Geje's got to be careful of those rising Muay Thai knees. Here come the chance again for Geje. Overhand right from Marias. Geje powers back, shoots in with Marias. Geje looks to stuff it, and he does.
Oh, good job by Geje to remain on his feet. Now he's got double underhooks. Let's see what he can do with this. See if he changes. Oh, good shrug of the shoulder there to take the back of Marias.
Trying to reach into the canvas. Not allowed to suplex here. Oh, how about this from Marias?
Beautiful dive there, rolled right into the leg lock. That's a knee bar. He's trying to go under the armpit now. Ah, that's tight, but Geje's got to push. He's got to push. Use that other leg. Use the left leg to create space, and he's out.
Geje out of trouble. Under a minute remaining now. This match on fire in the final round. And Geje a takedown. A back and forth contest. Chance for the knees, and Geje throw for the shoulder. A roll through again for the champ.
Again, attacking the leg with the knee bar. Geje is consistently getting the back position. Now he's got the back a little bit, but you can see Marias is coming on top and attacking the leg.
Under 30 seconds remaining. It is defeat. I can't hear myself thinking here in Studio City. Marias top position. The ground and pound from the champion. In half guard now. Can he pass?
And Marias might have actually let go, so a little bit of controversy there with what the corner, I think that's what the corner was jumping into the ring about, but man, what a match!
Absolutely incredible unification bout, one for the ages.
It's hard to tap with your fist though, Michael. You know, you don't really tap with punching like that.
They call Studio City Asia's entertainment capital, and it doesn't get any more entertaining than that. And there is a VIP moment. Both men on their knees. Values, inspiration, passion. It's the Bushido spirit, the martial arts spirit here that defined one championship and our amazing athletes. That respect, you won't see it anywhere else. On their knees, talking to each other. A VIP moment. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this match, we have Joe Andres, Property President, Studio City, Macau. And now, after five rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this bout in favor of the red corner. Judge number two scores this bout in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three scores this bout in favor of your winner by split decision. And now, the undisputed one flyweight world champion from the blue corner.
It's gold to the Philippines! It's gold to the Philippines! It's gold for Geje Eustaquio! A true Rocky story unfolds in one championship!
Believe it, a fairy tale come true, a Rocky story realized. The gold goes back to Baguio City, it goes back to the Philippines, it goes around the waist of Geje Eustaquio.
Yes, watch out for headbutt, low blow back of the head and spine, in for five rounds. Touch guard if you want, back your corner.
5 rounds for the strawweight championship of the world. Joshua Pacio, overweight kid who turned his life around through martial arts, says he wants to use his fame and success to inspire the uninspired in the Philippines. Can he take them championship gold here tonight? Michael Chavello, Mitch Chilson with you. It's Mixed Martial Arts Global Rule Set. This one for the big one. Left hook early from Joshua Pacio in the red, and an outside thigh kick from the Filipino. This match brought to you by UC 1000, lemon water and orange water. Rehydrate and protect.
You can see Joshua Pacio has a little bit lower stance than usual, has his hands a little bit lower, possibly looking to defend the takedown with underhooks and sprawl a bit heavy. He's immediately starting to attack the legs of Naito, because I think he saw that Alex Silva was able to exploit the leg kicks in the title match that Naito lost. So he's using a lot of leg kicks because he knows that this might be a weakness for Nobita.
Pacio did say that Naito striking would be his undoing. And you see Naito trying to get this contest to ground. Good sprawl out there from Pacio. Throws a knee. Nicely done from the Filipino. Bounce back up to his feet, and Angel breaks off. Just got out of the waiver. Bolo scooping up a cut there from Pacio.
Pacio looks extremely relaxed. That was a telegraph takedown. Easy sprawl by Pacio.
Maito went for a low single, Sakuraba style. Good counter there from Pacio. The heavy artillery off the hands. Would he become the fourth Team Lakay world champion? Folayang, Eustaquio, Benario. The next name be Pacio. So fifth, actually, Kevin Belingon too. Fifth Team Lakay world champion. So many of them. It's incredible success. Belingon, he will be against Pacquiao Fernandez in Singapore in November. There's a great shot from Pacio. He sprawls out. Here come the right hands from the Filipino. The aggression early on from the Patrick.
I think he hurt him with that body kick. You can see him wilt a little bit. Pacio went to the left hook to the body. Now he was attacking the hook body again on the ground.
What a start here from Joshua Pacio.
This match is starting to look a lot like their first encounter.
What was the undoing of Pacio 2 years ago, Mitch?
He made one mistake. He was in there for a takedown, and immediately you could see that Naito jumped on the back, sunk in that rear naked choke. One minor mistake on Pacio's part, and the night's over. But Pacio, he's now attempting to take Naito's back.
He said he'd like to do the passion lock. To do that, he's got to take Nobita's back. He's got to put him in a rear naked choke and then sink in the chicken wing.
Look at the way he's setting up that arm. He gave an instructional video on one championship, on OneFC.com, or the One Super app for this exact move. He's controlling the underside on that arm. He's got the underhook. Now he's going to try to threaten the choke and then pull that arm back.
Is he setting up the passion lock on Naito? That would be incredible. Joshua Pacio, the 22-year-old, dominating here in the first round. Under mixed martial arts rules, our global rule set for the World Strawweight Championship. Taking his time, thinking it through here, Pacio. Where does Nobita go from here?
Well, he's got to turn into him. He's using the cage. You might want to try to spin around, but he's got one hand controlling on that side. Now you can see him, he's trying to go chest to chest. He does a good job of that, but Pacio sprawls very heavy. Good defense by Pacio. Naito can't reach the legs like that. He's got to set that up a little bit more carefully.
Already a lot of reddening on the back of the knees of Naito, courtesy of the leg kicks from Pacio. 50 seconds remaining. First round set for 5. Takedown attempt there from Naito. Pacio sprawls out, tries to trap him in a choke attempt here. Naito out of trouble, looks for a head kick on the breakoff.
Good job by Pacio. He saw that overhand right. He knew that's how Naito likes to enter the takedowns, and he sprawled very heavily. He did it again. He threw that overhand right, goes in for the entry, goes after the legs. Pacquiao knew it was coming, sprawled heavily, but now he's got his hips up against the cage. Now it's going to be a little harder for him to sprawl. He's going to try to take that single leg, but I think he's going to run out of time.
You get the feeling that Naito might like to try to drag this one to deep water. Naito has been to the fifth round four times in his career. Joshua Pacquiao has never been beyond three rounds.
Look at Pacquiao looking nice and relaxed. Ate a bit of a high kick there, but immediately answered back with a nice little hook, straight hook combination. Pacquiao attacks the body, but I think before that, before he got hurt, he threw a nice kick to the body, and that was initially what did the damage. He lunged in there, caught him with the left hand to the body again, but then when Naito shot in for the legs, you could see Pacquiao continually attacking the body again. Good first round for the 22-year-old Joshua Pacquiao.
Big hello to all of our fans watching in the Philippines, cheering on Joshua Pacquiao on ABS-CBN Sports in Action. And those in Japan on Abima TV, cheering on the champion, Yoshitaka Naito, from inside the sold-out Jakarta Convention Center in Indonesia. Second round, mixed martial arts action. For the strawweight championship,
ready?
Scheduled for five. Pacquiao in the red. Champion Naito in the navy blue.
Ooh, beautiful time knee right as Naito is coming in. Bingo, hit him with a right knee.
Roundhouse kick to the rib cage there from Pacquiao. Nobito took some punishment to the legs, and there goes Pacquiao back to that lead thigh of the champion. Wasn't a great opening round for Nobita. Tries to thread the right hand, sprawls out as Pacquiao. Locks onto a single leg now does Naito. What can he do from here, Mitch? What are the options?
If these relentless attacks from Naito, he's consistently attacking after the legs. Joshua's got to be very careful here. He's trying to suck in the leg right here. So you can see him controlling the ankle, the left ankle of Pacquiao, which is going to try to pull that foot away from Joshua Pacquiao and put his butt onto the mat just like that. Now he's gonna roll up. Joshua's doing a good job of defending here.
All tied up like a pretzel here in the second round. This is what Nobita does so well. Always thinking, always planning, always plotting. The champion. And what's going on there with the leg of Nobita?
Good job by Joshua. You can see he was trying to get sucked in. Nobita was trying to pull the legs in, but Joshua's hips are so heavy, he was able to control the position. Now he pushes off. Back to the feet.
Nobita edges forward again. The champion, right of screen. Body shot there from Pacquiao, going for the bread basket. Goes the head kick on Nobita. Beautifully done from the Pacquiao. Overhand right, goes for a shot. Good sprawl out again from Pacquiao. Nice takedown defense. Fake right hand there from Nobita. Very wide stance on the champion. Goes to the body. Sprawl out again from Pacquiao, doing everything right so far in defense here, Mitch.
That he is doing, because remember, it's just like in the first exchange these two had. It was two rounds. Joshua was stopping the takedowns. Look at this, he's taking the back now, setting up that possible passion lock again.
Mitch, talk us through the passion lock again. What's the mechanics of it? What happens in the passion lock?
Well, what he's doing right now, he's got the back, he's got both hooks in. He controls the underside arm with his underhook. So he has that underhook on the right side of Nobita. Now, he's gonna threaten the choke to get Naito thinking about the choke, but he's really aiming for that hand. Now he doesn't really quite have the wrist yet. Pacquiao is trying to control the wrist on the right side, but he's also trying to threaten the choke. And that's what he's gonna do. He's gonna pull the arm behind when Naito's thinking about the choke, and he's gonna try to kimura it basically into a chicken wing and crank on that shoulder. It's an extremely painful move. He was trying to take the arm completely off Pung Sri Mitsati when he walked it in.
He called it the rear naked chicken wing. He dubbed it the passion lock on the night. It's become one of the viral sensations online. So many thousands of fans have watched the passion lock from Joshua Pacquiao. And he seems to be in control again here in the second round. Nobita, the champion, maybe looking for a way back to his feet. He posts up on the right arm. and Pacio keeping him down.
A few people, Michael, have called it a hammer lock, but I like the passion lock much better.
Right hand transitions into a takedown attempt and top position now for Pacio. This is some good stuff we're seeing from Joshua Pacio of the Philippines, Mitch.
He is definitely seizing the moment here tonight. But, I mean, these are the things, these are the small little things, these small little mistakes. At any moment, Naito can jump on your back and choke you out. That he does this so well. He lures people into a false sense of security, and right when you think you're fully, you know, you're winning the match, boom, it's over, and you're going to sleep.
Butterfly hooks now from Pacio. 45 seconds remaining, second round of five of this mixed martial arts main event for the strawweight championship of the world. Japan versus the Philippines, Naito and Pacio. Inside the guard of Pacio now. Naito top position. What can he do from here? He drops an elbow across the jawline. Good work from Nobita. Goes to the body with the left hand.
Naito likes to draw people into deep water and then suffocate them. And that's what he's doing right here. You know, he might have lost these first two rounds, but now we're starting to see that championship experience. You know, how many times has he been into the fourth and fifth round? He does his best work in that deep water.
He's been to the fourth and the fifth round, I should say, four times in his career. Here's the ground up. Pacio off his back. What a round. We go to the towels once again.
That was a close second round. You know, a little bit, you know, into the, you can see Naito starting to pour it on, starting to get control of a lot of these grappling exchanges. But man, Pacio is looking sharp. His striking is on point. His takedown defense is looking real good. This kid is rising to the occasion.
Okay, Mitch, let's play coach for a moment. If you're in Nobita's corner, what are you saying to the champion?
I'd like to see him mix it up a little bit more. Right now, he's only throwing that overhand right to a double leg takedown. He's got to try to put a little bit more of a combination together. Throw a 1-2 hook to the body, then go to the legs. He's not really setting these up very well. He can also maybe start catching some of the kicks of Pacio. Catch the kicks driving for the takedown.
Remember, folks, under this mixed martial arts global rule set, we do not score round by round. The bout is judged in its entirety by the three judges here cage side. And what a sight is right. The sold-out Jakarta Convention Center, alive in a happening. Third round of five in our championship main event.
You can see Naito looks a little bit more aggressive, looks a little bit more agitated.
Beautiful popping right hand to start there from Pacio, sprawls out. Now Pacio on his back trying to execute a choke here.
Nice little takedown there, though. Joshua went down a little bit without much of a fight at all. But this is where Naito really starts to excel. He starts to just grind on his opponents, outworking his opponents on the ground, landing little shots. He controls the hips very well of his opponents, consistently sucking in their hips, controlling their movement.
Top position for the champion. Yoshitaka Naito, the comic book lover from Japan. Lost the title to Alex Silva, won it back in the rematch. This, another rematch from 2 years ago. On that occasion, Naito the victor. Pacio believes he can sink the passion lock on the champ to take the gold back to Baguio City. A very hard ask against the guy as good on the ground as Yoshitaka Naito.
Good job of Pacio to get out of the guard and gets, now he has got these underhooks here. He's able to use them to get out of the position. Good job from Pacio.
Inside leg kick from Pacio. Nicely done to that back leg. Orthodox stance on both men. Naito faking and fainting. Can he get the hands off here? The champion goes in for a double leg. Couldn't execute a takedown. Good defense again from Pacio. Locks onto a single, does Naito.
Look at the way he sucked in that leg, Michael. He was able to trap that leg, use his own leg to sweep it underneath, and use that to get Pacio under the ground.
Although Naito not always successful on his takedown attempts here, Mitch, is he the aggressor, constantly going for the takedowns against Pacio?
Well, we score in two ways, Michael. We score with takedown defense, and we score in takedowns. So if Joshua Pacio is able to stop the takedowns, it's going to disrupt Naito's scoring. But if Naito consistently hunts for him and he transitions, he chain wrestles, so he's going for multiple takedowns, it's gonna score as well. So they both score, but takedowns score a little bit higher than takedown defense.
We're now halfway through the match, our main event here in Jakarta. Wherever you're watching in 138 countries around the world, we hope you're loving every moment of this martial arts magnificence. Half guard position one for Joshua Pacio in the red trunks from the Philippines. Can he land some ground and pound? Where does the beater go from here?
Oh, Michael, you missed it though, but in that transition, Pacio was able to use a butterfly sweep to end up on top. So you could see Naito trying to apply pressure from the top position, and Pacio was able to utilize an underhook on the leg, sweep him up over and change the position. But that's the grappling of Naito to get back on top.
You know my mistake, Mitch? I blinked, and these two guys are so damn fast on the ground. You can't even blink. You take your eyes off them for a millisecond, and they're doing something crazy.
Man, let those eyes dry out. You don't want to miss any of this action, because Naito's back on top, doing what he does best, grinding, outworking his opponents.
So what does Pacio do off his back here?
Pacio, he's trying to push off the hips, you know, so he's trying to keep a very active guard. He's not just keeping his guard closed, attempting, you know, to hold on to Naito, waiting for a stand-up. From here, you can see him consistently push. Now he's got the butterfly hooks, and he's going to try to trap one arm and sweep him to one side, or put the feet on the hips and push away.
Obita has become a master of decision wins. He's got six of them in his career. Now Pacio would like to finish the champion, to claim the gold, to take it back to Baguio City, to inspire the uninspired in the Philippines, just like his heroes, Eduard Folayang and Manny Pacquiao. 40 seconds remaining, third round of five. This has been a fantastic contest on the ground.
Pacio's only got two blemishes on his record, and they've come both from Japanese athletes by rear naked choke. So that's been his Achilles heel. And you can see Naito's trying to collapse the legs. He's trying to push the legs down and pass the guard. But Pacio's really shown improvements in his guard. His ability to keep his legs in front of his opponents and keep them wrapped around his body.
Naito can finish you at any moment. When he won the Shooto strawweight title in 2014, he submitted Shinya Murafuji with just 3 seconds remaining in the fifth round. He can lock them on from anywhere at any time, Yoshitaka Naito. We're gonna go into the fourth round of five. Now we are getting into that deep water.
So you blinked, Michael, so let's take a look at it here. Look at the guard of Pacio. He's able to control the feet on the hips, and he's looking to get one leg inside. You can see one foot underneath the leg right here. Right here, that left leg, he elevates him up and he sweeps him over. Beautifully done butterfly sweep right there from Pacio. Beautifully done. So we're starting to see the improvements, like we talked about at the beginning of the broadcast, the improvements in the ground game of the passion, Pacio.
Pacio says the loss to Naito 2 years ago in Myanmar humbled him. He considers it a blessing, a huge learning tool. And now he finds himself in the fourth round against the champion in front of a sellout crowd in Jakarta. What a night Conquest of Heroes has been. Two more rounds remaining in our main event.
All right, ready?
Cage ready? Door closes.
Choke!
Here we go, fourth of five, mixed martial arts global rule set. And Pacio comes out with a left hook. Haven't really seen Nobita get his best strikes off tonight, as we did see him last time against Alex Silva in their rematch. Makes a leg kick to Nobita. Takes a leg kick from Pacio.
This is uncharted water for Pacio. He's never seen a fourth round. He's never been into the championship rounds. But he's doing a good job so far of stopping this takedown and landing some significant strikes of his own.
How many hours do you think they trained the sprawling of Joshua Pacio in the lead up to this one, Mitch?
You know, Team Lakay has been criticized for years that the grappling game is their Achilles heel, but now we're starting to see some huge improvements from every single one of their athletes on the ground.
One of the powerhouse teams in all of Asia, indeed in the martial arts world, Team Lakay. Look at the champions they boast. Eduard Folayang, Geje Eustaquio, Kevin Belingon, Honorio Benario, all have held or do hold world titles. That is amazing for the team from Baguio City in the Philippines.
Can you imagine what their walls must look like? Just covered in belts.
Body shot there from Naito, falls short. Body shot from Pacio, fires the uppercut. Outside leg kick. A shade of red on the lead thigh of Yoshitaka Naito. In fact, it's now a kaleidoscope of color. Taking some punishment courtesy of that back shin of Joshua Pacio. Nobita not committing to the roundhouse kick. And again, Pacio finds the mark on the lead quadricep. That leg's got to be hurting Nobita. And that leg damage will make it harder for Nobita to shoot in on Pacio.
You know, he just did right there, and he's able to get that single leg. Beautifully done. Little turnaround takedown off the single leg there for Naito. Pacio's trying to hold on to the head, trying to elevate him now. But we're seeing some like superior striking from Pacio earlier.
Okay, Mitch, we're almost midway through the fourth round of five. Let's play coach again. What are you telling Nobita to do right now?
Nobita, he's got to show ground control. He's able to get Pacio down, so he's scoring the takedowns. But B, he's not advancing his position, and that's what shows ground control. You can see he hasn't been able to get past the guard. I might have spoke too soon as he's knifing that knee right through the guard there of Pacio, but Pacio does a beautiful job of maintaining the guard. So he's got to advance his position. He's got to do damage. He's got to show aggression by landing some ground and pound, and he's got to advance his position.
And what would Mark and Team Lakay be telling Joshua Pacio right now with just under 2 minutes remaining in the penultimate round?
Pacio's doing a beautiful job on the ground here. Look at him, he's attempting to go for Kimuras. He's consistently attacking. He's trying to maintain the position, but I think he really wants to get up, just like he did now, but he made a slight mistake. Good little scramble, but he is able to get back up to his feet. Beautiful dive.
Naito wants to put him down again. Oh, look at the elbows on the collarbone there of Naito. And Pacio on his back again. What can the champion do from here? Top position for Yoshitaka Naito.
Nice little transition from Naito, but again, he's not able to get past the guard of Pacio. Now he's into half guard, so now he's going to try to flatten out that arm. There's a possible arm triangle here on that side, but Pacio's got to keep his arm underneath, try to get underneath the head there. That's what he's doing. Good job. But while he's doing that, Naito's taking that leg out.
Mitch, what do you see as the biggest threat for Joshua Pacio?
At the moment, there's not a lot. You know, Naito is not doing a lot as far as ground and pound. You know, he's not able to advance his position, so he can't get past the guard of Pacio. But his biggest mistake, or his biggest possible mistake, is to make one minor error. And that's where Naito really starts to excel and shows that championship medal is by capitalizing on any mistake that they're going to make.
Inside Pacio's guard, the flurry of ground and pound from Yoshitaka Naito. And Pacio trying to create some distance. Rattles punches to the side of the champion's head. Tries to control his posture. Closes up the guard now. Naito trying to blast his way up. Trying to posture up and land the ground and pound. Ferocious stuff here from the champion. Good work from Naito. Body shots there from Naito and reverse elbows from Pacio. What a way to end this round. We're going to go into the fifth and final. It's the deepest of deep water. It's somewhere Pacio has never been before.
Wow, just at the bell, there was a brief moment where Naito was able to finally get past the guard and end up in mount. I don't know how the judges are going to score that. Look at some of the beautiful work here from Pacio. Landed a nice little combination, exiting on the hook. But here's Naito on top, trying to work past the guard. And then just at the moment, look at that. He goes out the back door, right? He was about to give up mount, and Pacio was able to get up and stand back up. Good job, Pacio.
Can you believe it? We are going to go into the fifth and final round of the main event here in Jakarta for the World Strawweight Championship. There's the champion, Yoshitaka Naito. Everybody here in Jakarta on the edge of their seats. We've got ourselves a sellout. And Mitch, it's all come down to this really quickly now. Once again, Pacio, what does he need to do?
Pacio needs to keep this on the feet because we're starting to see the champion start to get his groove, finding the mistakes and advancing his position. Pacio needs to sprawl heavy and let those hands go.
And how about the champion? What does he have to do for the next 5 minutes?
The champion's got to get this to the ground, and he's got to do damage. He's got to do significant damage to Pacio on the ground, maybe on the feet here, but he's got to do something big.
And already you see a little more pepper, a little more mustard out of Yoshitaka Nayuta. There's a certain gusto about the champion. Now, a high kick from Pacio. Nobita working angles, those awkward angles, the little quarter turns, the little pirouettes. It's the fifth round of our world title main event, Mixed Martial Arts Global Rule Set in action. Outside leg kick from Pacio. Nobita in center cage. Pacio tried to scoop the right hand. Will the goal go back to Japan? Will it go to the Philippines?
Yeah, we're pretty close either way, but we're starting to see Naito definitely has a little bit more urgency behind a lot of these engagements. You know, he's starting to push forward, and Pacio's slowing down just a little bit. And just as I said that, he lands a big knee. Look at the sacrifice. What he does is he pulls guard into the half guard, and now he's able to get control of the hips. Let's see if he can reverse him.
Top position here for Pacio. Could he find a sub from this position? The 22-year-old from Baguio City in the Philippines goes onto his back here. Top position now for Nobita.
Great reversal there from Naito. He was able to get that single leg, transition out, get back on top. It's a bad spot for Pacio to be in.
So what are the options for the champion here, Mitch?
Well, you can probably wait a little bit. Oh, look at that. Look at it. Beautifully done. Minor mistake. He was trying to pass the half guard into mount, and Pacio was able to slide out, end up on top, and get out.
Nobita wants Pacio on the canvas. There he goes now. Pacio trying to sink some sort of choke attempt. Nobita looking to pass the guard. Goes there. Well done from the champion. What's Nobita looking for here, Mitch?
You can see Joshua's trying to get the legs around one of the legs. So he's trying to catch a leg to get back into half. And that was the battle right there. But Naito looks to be winning it right there on the right leg. Pacio's trying to get back into the half guard, but good job by Naito to nullify that.
Once again, Yoshitaka Naito has been to the fifth round now 5 times in his career. This is very familiar territory. Pacio before tonight had never been past a third round. This is usually where Naito is so strong, where he usually powers up, where he usually owns opponents in the fifth, the final, the championship round.
Good scrambles by Pacio, but I think he gave up the mount. He's back in half guard. Yup, he's back in half guard, but look at the way Naito is able to float around. Almost back in that side control, but good job by Pacio to pull him back into guard to stop the advancing of position from Naito. But he hops over, now he's back into a possible side control, but a good sweep there from Pacio.
Pacio hunting after the left arm of Nobita. Can he find something here? The passion! The passion! Can he take home that arm? If he takes it home, he'll take home the gold as well. But no, Nobita seems to be okay.
It's going to be really hard. All he can do to use this kimura for is a sweep to control the position.
What to finish?
Naito might try to roll the other way. And he does, and he gets up and continually attacks the leg.
The high IQ of the champion gets him out of that predicament. And now Nobita looking to take it to ground. They go there. What does Pacio do from here, Mitch?
Well, he's trying to push his head away to create a little bit of space and not give up side control. Naito looks to be getting pretty close to it. Yep, now he's got side control. Good advance on the position from Naito. Pacio's gonna scramble though, try to get out, and he does. Attacks the leg.
Back up under their feet. Final minute, fifth and final round. Drops down to take the legs from under Pacio. Pacio trying to maintain his vertical base. What a thrilling, gripping final round of action. Indeed, this entire World Championship main event has been extraordinary. 40 seconds on the clock now, Mitch.
Look at that back and forth action from both these guys. Naito is continually trying to pass the guard, but look at Pacio able to keep the guard in place.
Champion, 20 seconds to the final seconds. Pacio defends. This
It's so close. It's razor thin. Is he going to finish on top of the champion? Yes, it looks like it. What a contest between two superb martial artists at the height of their powers. My word, that was phenomenal. And look at the respect, and look at the replay.
There was a little bit of a light touch on the leg kick, but Pacio was able to counter with a leg kick of his own. Had a big left hook to punctuate that exchange. Here's Naito continually scrambling, always looking for something, always trying to move forward. Has that ground control. Look at this, he's able to end up on top in the exchange. Goes after the leg again, and I think he was able to secure the takedown there at the end of that grappling scramble. But man, what back and forth action. I have got to say, I am extremely impressed, win or lose, with Pacio's improvement in the grappling.
The judges must decide. Three judges came side, scoring on an overall bout, not round by round. Will it be Joshua Pacio, the 22-year-old from Baguio City of the Philippines, becoming Team Lakay's fifth world champion, alongside Filipino, Benario, Belingon? This team is incredible. Or does Nobita retain the title? Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision and new world strawweight world champion, Joshua Pacio!
It's a new world champion! It's a Filipino world champion! The passion, Joshua Pacio's first gold at 22 years old! What a moment! Joshua Pacio! Outthinking! Out-strategizing!
Low blow, back of the head and spine. I want a clear, fair fight. Third blow if you want, and back your corner.
Olivia Cox with the final instructions. In front of a sellout crowd inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. It's our main event of one championship, Heart right, of the Lion.
Judge,
Bibiano
judge,
Fernandez.
Ready,
Kevin Belignon.
Choke
for the bantamweight championship of the world. Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. Belignon in the red. Fernandez in the black. It may very well be the raw power of Belignon, the finesse and technique of Bibiano Fernandez.
You see Kevin throwing that lead hook. That's how he sets up that spinning kick. He's looking for the spin early. Bibiano testing the leg right there.
We saw the turning back kick to the liver of Andrew Leone. One of the most spectacular kicks we've ever seen. It sent Leone a full 10 feet across the ring on that night. Was the beginning of the end for Leone. And there it is from Belignon, turning back it to the liver.
That's one to the body already.
Jab from Belignon, outside fly kick from Bibiano, looking to drop down for a single leg there, the Brazilian. Belignon saying he received a groin strike, and a moment's break here called by referee Olivia Cox. Certainly the aggressive start though from Kevin Belignon here, Mitch. He's turning early. He's trying to line up the power salvo.
That's what he said. He wanted to attack the body. This is the exchange. Bibiano went low right there as he was attempting an inside leg kick. Yes, he went back up. A flurry of punches. He was looking for the takedown. The takedown wasn't there. It came over the top. Did tap the groin.
Just a caution there from our referee Olivia Ghost. Accidental groin strike, of course, but you hit the groin and the pain receptors kick in. So a moment to recover here for Kevin Belignon, who's already showing his hand very early on in this world title match. We can see the game plan here of Kevin, as you said, to go to the body of Bibiano Fernandez. They believe that's the weakness. They believe that's the chink in the armor of Bibiano Fernandez.
This is how he likes to set up, right there to the low, right there. No denying that it happened. You can almost hear the crack.
guy shakes it off, being the pro that he is, ready to put in work.
They recommence here in the first round of action. Look for the body work again from Belingon, the man with the flowing mullet. Fernandez, the bantamweight champion, the greatest champion in ONE history, never beaten here in ONE.
He's got that reach advantage. I'd seen throughout that jab, so testing the distance.
Oh, he just put Bibi on the jaw with that short left hand. Bibi dropping low levels to try and lock onto a leg to take down Belingon. Belingon does not want to go to the ground with Fernandez. Fernandez, double leg here, trying to get the Filipino down. Belingon not going there, however. Body shot from Belingon.
Be a good first test for Kevin Belingon's takedown defense. He looked stellar against Martin Nguyen in the takedown defense, but Bibiano is a different breed of grappler. Look at him attacking the legs. Look at Kevin. Good defense so far. He's got to be careful. That's where you want to go.
Inside of half guard here. Bibi Fernandez, top position, peppering palm strikes to the side of the head of Kevin Belingon. How Belingon finds himself in Bibi land. How does he defend against the several submission attempts and the ground and pound that Bibi can bring from these positions?
First thing he needs to do is take that right arm and start looking for an underhook. In half guard position, if he can get an underhook underneath the left arm of Bibiano, he's going to be able to turn onto his side. Now he's got the arms trapped on the other side, so he's got the half guard on the other side. That's what he needs to start doing. He needs to get one side on the underhook. Because right now he's got his half guard on the left leg of Bibiano and the underhook on the other side, the right side of Bibiano. So he's kind of trapped himself in this position. Bibiano can apply pressure with his shoulder and look to pass the guard. Kevin needs to create movement in this space. He doesn't want to give Bibiano the opportunity to start setting things up.
Fernandez, a BJJ sensation, five-time world champion, three-time Pan American champion, has won 11 gold medals in elite BJJ competitions around the world. It's been an aggressive start from
Bibi.
Don't
run the fence, guys. Don't run the fence.
Try to finish a quickly, try and take Belingon into deep water. Fernandez has a proven gas tank. He's gone five rounds, five times in his career, winning all five times by decision.
No technique on the escape right there. Pure explosion to get out of the half guard there of Bibiano Fernandez.
Resets here. This Belingon has power in the legs.
Oh, a turning back kick to the liver. And then one to the head. He tries to take his head off. The headache maker for Belingon. He's put the power early. And Fernandez looked a little shocked momentarily. Especially the spinning hook kick to the head. There's another turning back kick to the liver.
He was right. They are definitely going after the body with that spinning back kick. And look how fast he comes out of that. There's almost no setup. He's not even throwing that hook. It's just an explosion into that turning back kick.
The liver, a very large organ in the upper right portion of the abdomen, highly vascular area. A shot to the liver can be excruciatingly painful.
First set is left in the first round.
Martial articles say the most painful way to get knocked out is with a liver shot. Turning back to the liver again there from Belingon. It's about the size of a football, the liver. Right side of the body. Mostly protected by the rib cage, but still slightly exposed. And if you dig in between the 9th and 10th rib, you hit that vagus nerve, it can close down the entire body. That's what Belingon's looking to do with his turning back kick. There's one from Bibi Fernandez. But my word, what a start here from Kevin Belingon. He went straight to the game plan. He showed his hand. There's the new VP, Misha Tate. There's Mighty Mouse, Demetrius Johnson. So many luminaries here, cage side in Singapore for ONE Championship.
This is what they're watching. That was spinning back kick landed, not close to the liver, but up top a little bit. That one was hunting again after it. He is repeatedly going after that. But that up top kick was a beautiful spinning heel kick. Caught Bibiano high on the guard, veteran that he is, caught that kick.
Okay, Mitch, play coach for a moment. If you take Lakay, what are you telling Kevin Belingon to do?
Kevin Belingon is putting things together beautifully right now. Their game plan is working to the T. I'd like to see Kevin Belingon set that up a little bit, throw the jab, get him thinking about the hands first, get Bibiano lift his hands up, then spin the attack to the body. Bibiano, he's got to move forward. He's a little bit tentative there in the last couple, about 90 seconds of that first round. He started to slow down a bit. He was watching careful to the body.
Ready?
Likes to Bibiano throw the hands and start to chain wrestle with him. Back Kevin up against the cage and take him down and grind on him.
Singapore has been a happy hunting ground for Bibiano Fernandez. It was here in 2013 that he won the title. Well, to unify the one bantamweight world title by Benny Sutil Kim. Oh, good right hand, stiffly there from Belingon. Bibi tries to thread the right hook, turning back into the liver. Bibi backs it up with the right hand. Double leg down from the Brazilian. Gets the takedown, and we're back in Bibi land. The half guard position. Let's see what Fernandez can do. The takedown has come early in the second round.
And we were set up with the hands. He was able to utilize the boxing, back Kevin up with the big right hand, get him up against the cage, and now he's grinding on him. Now Bibiano's going to start to slowly and methodically work on Kevin. He's got to slow him down a little bit. He's got to get Kevin to expend some energy. Kevin is extremely explosive. That's how he got out of the first exchange here on the ground. He was able to just throw Bibi off on him.
Let's go, guys.
The explosion, the fast twitch muscle fiber of Kevin Belingon is at an all-time high. Bibiano needs to slow him down.
It's got to serve well mentally for Kevin Belingon that he's out of the first round. Last time they met in 2016, Bibiano tapped out Belingon with a Kimura in just 4 minutes and 4 seconds. Here he is in the second round, and Belingon told us, I'm a completely different martial arts machine than I was last time we fought.
Every single one of Team Lakay always excels in the rematch. They go back, they've got their head coach who breaks everything down, and they always find a way to be much more successful in the second time around.
Fence.
When they run it back, Team Lakay, second to none.
Now we're on 19 and 5, 11 finishes, including 8 knockouts, 9 of those in the very first round. Scramble here. Going on back to his feet. Seems to be overwhelming Filipino support for Kevin Belingon in the crowd here in Singapore tonight.
And again, he exploded out of the technique.
And the chants go up for Kevin Belingon, the underdog here in Singapore. Spinning backwards, Bibi avoids it, tries to loop in the tag, and Belingon gets out of the way. What a matchup for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. It's one championship, Heart of the Lion, live from the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Got the right hand cocked and ready here, Belingon. Shifts off to his left. Bibi dead center of the cage. Jab there from Fernandez. Belingon taking his time. Very patient match so far from Belingon. Overhand right misses.
Everything Kevin throws is full force. There's no waiting out process, no setup. Everything is just one big shot trying to take that head off of Bibiano Fernandez. But good eyes from the veteran moving out well. And so Kevin is extending.
Oh, my word! He got airborne on that! Jump turning back kick to the belly button of Bibiano Fernandez. He must have been half a foot off the ground, Nick. That was incredible.
You hear the crash from that side kick.
Tucked down there from Fernandez. Now the Brazilian, up the intensity, up the aggression, takes the back of Belingon. Here's Bibiano. This is what Fernandez does so well. The body triangle locked on. And Belingon's got no place to go. Belingon could be in trouble here. Bibiano goes for the arm, Can he find the finish?
Kevin Belingon pushed the leg off of Bibiano. A straight escape. Threw the arm off, or threw the leg off rather. Saved the arm, but Bibiano still can't even accept the arm off. Bibiano is covered up. A lot of this is covered off. Those landed right there, though. Bibiano's laughing. He's okay.
Have a look at Belingon. It's about damn it, Singapore.
still attacking off his back. Threw up an armbar attempt right there. Now he's got the high guard. Look for him to go for a triangle. He's got one arm trapped there on the side. He's going to let it go. He's still got the arm trapped. Looking for the arm bar. Survived the back. Look at Bibby. Look at the way he's trapped that right left arm. Throws the leg over. Look at Kevin. Get off me. Get that leg off me. He's okay. I'm okay. Get that leg off. Bibiano covers back up. Still has that arm trapped. Look how he traps the arm with his leg. Hooks in like he's doing a hamstring curl. Completely has the arm trapped. Uses his right arm to attempt it again. Goes after it again. Kevin shrugs him off. Gets on top and drops the ground and pound. What a second round, Michael Schabella.
Kevin Belingon, more escapes than Michael Schofield in that round. And what have we got in store for you in the third? It's an absolute barn burner. Belingon first to emerge from his stall. Third round of five. We are heading towards that deep water. Bibiano's been there many times before. And this sellout crowd here in Singapore, loving every moment of a truly epic main event. Let's see if Belingon goes back to that river with the turning Wushu back kicks. Belingon began his martial arts career in Wushu. Was awarded a Wushu scholarship to the University of Encordilleras. Then he's moved to Baguio City, and then of course joined the great Team Lakay. Here's a Philippines national Wushu champion. And we've been seeing some of that Wushu striking. Belingon just falling short with that right hand. Overhand right there. Here's the turning back into the midsection, trying to put the belly button through the back. Bibi measuring with the jab, resets now. Good right hand lead there from Fernandez.
The reach of Bibiano, that's what makes him so effective on the stand-up. He just utilizes that reach so very well. You can see Kevin throws big, wide, looping shots. You can see how his elbows are nice and flared. That leaves a hole right through the middle. Bibiano's trying to exemplify, he's trying to exploit it, but Kevin is throwing everything with still 100% power.
His main sparring and training partner, Mighty Mouse Demetrius Johnson here at cage side. Bibiano Fernandez going for title defense number 10. Mighty Mouse has had 11 of them. Two amazing, complete martial arts warriors. Bibiano Fernandez finding himself right now in the match of his life. The crowd in Singapore against him. Kevin Belingon has brought the heat from the opening bell. But we saw the flash of Bibiano. The flash of the flash Fernandez in the second round when he came agonizingly close to taking home Kevin's arm.
Very close, but Kevin came just as close to going with the body. Those shots are going to start to pay dividends later in the match. Going to start to wear down Bibiano. Bibiano is not as fast as slow, but he's still landing with these shots.
Smith a jab, two from Bibiano, left to go from Belingon. 2 minutes, 40 remains, third round of five. The Philippines versus Brazil. Almost caught him with the counter right hand there. And a snappy jab from Belingon. But Bibiano had the right idea. When Belingon commits that turning back into the liver and he misses the target, the follow, the counter right hand could come smack bang on the kisser.
And where have we seen that before?
It's a new one. Give it to Eduard Folayang.
That could be the answer to that little riddle right there. Kevin's shown his hand. He says, I'm going to spin. Bibiano has got to circle out to the side and land that hand over right hand.
Mitch, at any point here, do you feel that Belingon is going to the well one time too many, hunting after that turning back into the liver, that it may become predictable and Bibi may start to really time off it?
He's probably up near the double digits in attempting that spin kick. Bibiano's seen it, but he's got to avoid it. He can't take it over and over again. He's going to start to wear on it. and Kevin is throwing everything with full power. So you can see Kevin starting to slow down too. And listen to this crowd.
Single leg here, good ground. He's gonna get a takedown. 1:49:35. Already on the cage. Watching out for legs here for Nandez.
Interesting. Viviano could have went into side control, but he chose to shove the legs between his legs, trap him, and slowly try to work his way into mount.
Let's go, guys, work!
A tremendous contest right in front of our Chinese commentary team across the cage there. Top position, Kevin Belingon. Hope you enjoy your first live in 138 countries. They're live and free on the One Super App as Bibi Fernandez mounts Kevin Belingon.
And Belingon's got 45 seconds here. He's got to hold on tight to those arms, but now they're starting to be sweating, so Bibiano slid the arm out. Now he's going to go. Look how he has that left arm there. He's nice and high. Kevin's got to pull him tight. It's a bad spot to be in, though. This sets up an armbar. Watch his knees. If he chooses to go high, oh, he goes flat.
To finish.
Applies the pressure there. Now he's in the ground and pound position right now.
20 seconds remains. Third round.
That's the veteran right there, Bibiano. He knows that they're slippery right now, so Kevin could pull out of an armbar. So he chose to go heavy hits and soften him up and end the round in a very dominant position.
Postures up now. Fernandez tries to drop the angles on the head of Belingon. Snakes in a right hand. Three down, two to go.
That's a veteran move right there. He chose to not risk losing the position by going after the armbar. He flattened his hips out, softened Kevin up a little bit, went high right as the bell was about to ring, and just let the punches come down. And that, we don't go round by round. We go by the match in its entirety. But that is a great way to end 15 minutes right there, Mr. Spello.
Star-studded Team Lakay in the corner of Kevin Belingon. The landslide, Eduard Folayang, who in a few weeks' time in Manila will take on Amir Khan for the World Lightweight Championship. There's Bibiano Fernandez. We know he's seen it all before.
Fast and hard.
Do you feel that Fernandez underestimated Belingon at all, Mitch?
No, I don't think so. I think he's seen the past six matches. I think he's seen the improvements that Kevin's made, but he's also extremely confident in himself, and he knows the type of martial artist that he is, the type of athlete that he is, and also the type of strategist that he is. Everything that he's doing is very methodical at this point. These are the championship rounds. This is where Bibiano lives and breathes.
Let's go, guys.
The penultimate round. Jab in from Belingon. Jab from Bibiano Fernandez. Spinning heel kick from Belingon. Came close. Try to bring the heel to the temple. Cutting Wushu side kick to the knee there. Common Polonia move just above the knee. Jab from Belingon to put down the points. Fernandez jab two, didn't have the stops behind it though.
And he's still landing on Kevin. And that's what's giving him a little bit of just success in the stand-up, is he still landing with these shots. And now what that's gonna do, it's gonna create an opening for him to just like that, throw that overhand right, change levels, and go after those legs.
Two absolute warriors who have overcome a lot of adversity early on in life. Fernandez almost dying from malaria, contracted in the Amazon jungle, where he was fending for himself and hunting and gathering as a seven-year-old. Belingon had to go through some loss of family members, raiding of bandits in his childhood home in the Philippines, up to poverty. And here they are, both men, in the main event at the top of the martial arts world. Championship here in Singapore.
Up to finish.
Jumped over the half guard there, landed in side control. Kevin starts to look a little bit fatigued. This is not something we're used to seeing. That's that explosion that we're talking about. You can't explode out of like that. You have to make sure you're technical. You still got to maintain that technique, especially with a grappler like Bibiano Fernandez.
Once again, we are in the deep theater. As I said earlier, Fernandez, five times in his career, has gone the full five rounds, won all of those decisions.
Want to finish?
Doesn't look like Belignon's gas tank is slowing at all, even though he is the oldest statesman here. Side control for the Brazilian. 2 minutes 35 remaining, fourth of five. The bantamweight championship of the world. Oh, elbow to the top of the head there from Belignon, trying to open up a cut perhaps. Cuts in the hip a little here from side control, does Fernandez. Immediate attention surrounding this main event all week here in Singapore. It's been extraordinary. So many photographers and reporters from newspaper, radio, television, websites. Some groundbreaking news released in one championship this week.
Let's go, one to finish.
And we are seeing a fitting main event. Looks for the full mouth as Fernandez slips out the back. He tries to take the arm. Once again, Belignon is free. And this crowd loved it. Another escape from Belignon.
Hard to finish an arm bar this late in the match. They're so slippery, easy for them to pull out. But Belignon, once he gets a hold of that arm, he can stay tight with it. But Kevin is still so explosive, he's able to just power out of these shots or these attempts at submissions.
125 on the clock now. Bibiano's gotten Belignon to deep water. You see that the aggressive striking is not fair as it was in the opening two rounds from Belignon. It's still dangerous as ever. It's a demoralizing mix that Bibi's trying to done last and not securing them.
Not so much. I don't think he's demoralized. I think he's trying to figure out another solution. You could see him inside the side control, and he didn't want to give it up, but he's trying to finish. Bibiano is not the lay and pray. He's not going to stay there and just hold the position. He's going to try to finish you. He loves to finish his opponents, and he's always going to be looking for it. He made that as a calculated risk. It didn't pay off, but that's Bibiano Fernandez for you.
Fernandez controlling center.
30 seconds left in the fourth round.
Undefeated since 2010, Bibiano Fernandez. And what great names he's picked along the way. Antonio Banuelos, Yoshiro Maeda, Gretzel Kazaki, Sutro Kim, Ueda, Daehwan Kim, Tony Taru, Chris McCullough.
Oh, he got 6 to the round!
And Bibi back to his feet. There's damage on the bridge of the nose of Bibi Fernandez. Another top thumping right hand into the round. We're going into the fifth and final. This is crazy.
That's the power of the silencer. Out of nowhere, the tide can change. He put Bibiano on his backside with that beautiful right hand. Look at Bibiano, measuring, calculating, right through the middle with the right hand. Watch Kevin Belignon using that power to slip his way out. The BJJ World Champion goes after the submission as the armbar deep. Look at Kevin, no, not today. This is my moment to shine. Beautifully done, but what does Kevin still have? He still has that power in his right hand. The thunder in the right hand can be delivered at any moment. He's still dangerous. Still, even though he's tired, even though he's exhausted, he still has that one-hitter quitter, Michael.
Fifth and final round. 99% of pundits did not think it would get this far. But here we are, inside the sold-out Singapore Indoor Stadium for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. Who will prevail? They touch gloves. Outside leg kick from Fernandez, the champion. Outside leg kick again. What tremendous heart. What aggression, what power from the interim champion, Kevin Belignon. Turning back kick to the liver from Belignon. All right, Mitch, with 4 minutes 30 remaining, what does Belignon need to do?
He's going to have to land big. He's attacking that leg beautifully. You see how Viviano's limping a little bit on that leg? I think these things are starting to build up for him. But what's he doing? He's setting up that spinning back kick. He's going to keep going to the well. He's going to keep looking for that power. But what it's going to do is going to get Viviano to drop his elbows down to his body to protect the body shot. What's that going to do? That's going to open up the head. Kevin Belingon can still come over the top with a beautiful right hand. Viviano needs to work the jab. Needs to work the jab, set up that right hand, and look for the takedown. Put Kevin on his back and grind on him for the next 4 minutes. But he's got to get at least 2 minutes on the ground in a dominant position.
Time is ticking down. Fernandez sends a cut. Inside Mikey to a right hand. Good combination, Fernandez. Jab there from Belingon. Belingon looks for the outside lead leg. Can't find it. Lots of swelling around the brow of Kevin Belingon. Damage to the bridge of the nose of Viviano Fernandez. High kick from Belingon. Fernandez saw that one coming. Jump turning back kick. Bon Jovi style. Shot to the heart. Bibby resets. Will one of these two men put their foot down and go for it? Throw caution to the wind. Hell for leather with 3 minutes remaining. Is it time to pull out all the stops? Leg kick there from Belingon. And goes to the inside thigh.
Michael, at 20 minutes, I had Viviano slightly ahead, even though he was knocked down by that right hand. But at this point, Kevin is starting to inch forward. He's starting to land these strikes. He's starting to outstrike Viviano Fernandez. He's starting to connect more.
You wonder if with his experience, Viviano may be trying to go kleptomaniac and steal them in the final minute or so. Jab from Belingon. This one's close. There's no doubt about it. It could turn any moment.
This is an extremely close match. I think it might come down to the last 2 minutes. Either way, right now Kevin's starting to find his rhythm. He's starting to land shots. Viviano found his right home for that right hand just now.
Inside leg kick from Belingon, nice and high on that inside thigh.
There's a scoring, Michael. That's like the fifth one that's landed this round.
Belingon has been putting down the score with the striking here in the fifth. Bibi's got to change it up now. Got to go for something. Either the strikes or look for that takedown. Jabs from both men.
I think he needs a takedown. He doesn't want to stand here with Kevin lighting him up. That's what he goes after. Oh, Kevin gets away from Viviano Fernandez. Can he do that for another 90 seconds to keep on his feet? Keep going after that little inside leg kick.
Raised chickens. Looked like a greased chicken was here. Escaped Viviano Fernandez moments ago. Chance went up to Bellingham. Big outside fight here from Fernandez. That's 1 minute 10 remaining for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. Leg kick again from Bellingham. No doubt he's won the strike in this final round. Jab to Bellingham. Fernandez have left, he tries to catch him, but it's like catching greased lightning.
He's got to set that up better. He's got to throw those hands. He's got to get Kevin lifting up his hands to protect the head and then shooting for the takedown. Nice leg kick.
Counter off a leg kick with a right hand from Belingon. Threads the jab, does Viviano Fernandez. Under 40 seconds now. Leg kicks again from Belingon.
30 seconds left.
This is Belingon's world, man.
And the target prep of Belingon. On the back foot and out striking Fernandez. Fernandez has come forward. Belingon misses with a little kick. 15 seconds now. Is there one big salvo left in their Hail Mary shot? Final 10 seconds. This place going crazy. Belingon puts a fist in the air. He believes he's won it.
Michael Cervello. What back and forth action. Every round was razor close. So many different variables go into judging this matchup. The striking superiority of Kevin Belingon, the shots landed by Viviano Fernandez, the top control, the submission attempts. What an amazing unification bout between two world-class martial artists, two bantamweight world champions. Who is going to leave Singapore with the strap? Michael Cervello.
Chatri Singh is on the founder of ONE Championship to present the belt to the winner. Will it be Kevin Belingon? Will it be Viviano Fernandez? Wherever you're watching live in 138 countries, live and free on the ONE Super app, how do you score it? Does Belingon claim his 20th career victory? Does Fernandez get his 23rd? Does Belingon stop the streak of Fernandez, the winning streak that dates back to 2011? Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this bout in favor of the red corner. Judge number two scores this bout in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three calls this bout in favor of your winner by split decision. And now, the undisputed ONE Bantamweight Champion of the World, Kevin Belingon!
It's history made! Kevin Belingon, the Bantamweight Champion of the World! The reign of gold over the cage here in Singapore! The first man to beat Viviano Fernandez in ONE Championship. The first man to beat him since 2010.
Title shot, 5 minutes per round. No headbutting, no head throwing, do not put it back. Three fights. All time obeying my commands. Stop drops.
Final instructions from Yuji Shimada. A real sense of excitement. A very special atmosphere. This is what they came to see. This one could be a classic. You can feel the tension in the crowd. We are ready to go. Amir Khan bounds out of his corner. You may see the twitches of the eye, the jerking of the neck. It's the Tourette syndrome that Amir Khan has had all his life. The pro golfer, hoping to become Singapore's first ever homegrown world champion.
When I asked him about it, he says he never takes his eyes off opponents despite it. You know, the fans in here, they may have paid for the entire seat here at the Mall of Asia Arena, but they're only gonna need the edge of that seat tonight, Michael Cervello.
The familiar Team Lakay red trunks with the Filipino flag for Eduard Folayang, the former world champion. Hard-lift roundhouse kick out of southpaw stance for Khan. He's got the most knockouts in ONE Championship history. Folayang's got that wushu style, those powerful side kicks. Amir Khan is a Muay Thai stylist.
Khan switches stances very well. He floats between southpaw and orthodox effortlessly. He mixes in a lot of different styles. Oh, look at Folayang spinning already.
Both men coming close there. The high kick from Khan, the spinning back fist from Folayang. Outside low kick for Lyon, needs to bring the hands up afterwards, not to get counted. Celebrated his birthday yesterday, Eduard Folayang. Will he be given the gift of reclaiming championship gold? Big outside low kick, there's the counter from Khan I spoke about. Folayang must keep his hands up when he strikes.
Jack came off very fast.
Khan can knock you out from anywhere. He doesn't need much room. Could knock you out in a phone booth. The Singaporean checks the low kick, goes for the counter down the center corridor.
Khan seems very content to stay in orthodox. He's timing his jabs nicely. He's closing the distance very fast with that right hand as well.
Khan
back, switch up roundhouse kick from the Singaporean. Inside leg kick, misses the target. He loaded fully up on that, did Eduard Folayang.
Fully committed to these shots, Michael Schiavello. But having a little bit of distance, they blitz in, they blitz out. Oh, Khan goes after him, but look at that takedown from Eduard Folayang. He's in the guillotine.
Guillotine attempt here from the near guard. No avail though. They're on the floor for the first time. 2:20 remaining, first round. Now back on the feet, out of the guillotine attempt goes Folayang. Throws a knee to the upper left rib cage of Khan. Then goes down to the thigh. And once more to the thigh from Folayang. A real tussle against the wire here.
They got 50-50 position, and each one has an underhook, each one has an overhook. Now, look for the knees. Watch Folayang's knees. He's an expert. His hips are back. He's pressing off the cage with his butt so he can create a little bit of space to deliver those knees. Now he's got Khan up against the cage.
Break off. Some room for Khan to work his high kicks perhaps.
Khan looks to pack down a little bit of muscles since the last time we saw him. He's looking really thick.
Folayang, little flicking back fist there as Khan was almost off balance. Front kick from the Singaporean. Folayang resets, center of the cage. 1:25 remains now in the first round. We are set for five for the lightweight championship of the world. They clinch up again, drive Folayang back against the cage. Couple of knees off the right leg there from a former world champion.
Khan likes that overhand right. As Folayang's missing it, Khan's lunging forward, throwing that big right hand. Folayang's been able to evade it so far. A bit of time spent up that cage. The reversal by Khan is in the crowd.
Chance go up Folayang here in Manila, the sold out Mall of Asia Arena. It's one championship conquest of champions.
Nice knee landed by Khan, but you can see Folayang didn't like it. He's a little more cautious. Look at him guarding the hips with those hands.
Nice knee again to the midsection, trying to fold him in half like a piano accordion.
That was the plan of Khan. Go to the body early. Hurt him with push kicks and knees inside the clinch.
Some distance now for both men to get their strikes up. Who will land first with 20 seconds to go in the round? Front kick from Khan. Southpaw stance on the Singaporean. Looks for the inside leg, does Folayang. Oh, cutting Wushu's side kick to the lead thigh. An outside crescent kick. A little left hand over the top. Combination from Folayang. Spinning back kick. How do you do? There's the end of round one.
Wow, very close round. A lot of very, very close counters. You can see as one exchanges, the other one comes right back. The first part of that round was a lot of posturing, but look at this. Watch. Boom, big leg kick landed by Folayang. Khan saw that counter. He's starting to counter very well with those punches. He's waiting for Folayang to kick, and he's attacking the head with the punches. Then he starts going to the body. He's watched that rear push kick from Khan going to the body, and then watch the knees inside the clinch up against the cage. Inside that clinch, you can see Folayang started to protect his body from those knees with putting his hands on Amir's hips, just so he create a little bit of separation and also judge that distance. The second round, watch for Amir Khan to increase the volume of kicks that go to the body. He might even start throwing in the roundhouse off of the switch.
Amir Khan said, 100% I finish Folayang inside of three rounds. Folayang with this massive crowd behind him. Second round. The lightweight world title. Inside leg kick from the former champion. Amateur round there, caught in the forearms. Folayang inching forward. Sets himself a lot lower in his stance than Khan. Good side kick, that one aimed to the liver section.
Khan's got to do something about that push kick. He's got to start stepping off to the side.
Big left hook there, smack bang from Folayang. And Khan does a quick count of his teeth. When Eduard explodes, Mitch, he can explode.
He comes out so fast. He throws that left kick. Look at that switch. He comes so
side kick to the midsection, but it's a little low.
It looked a little bit low. It could have been seen as low, but Khan seems okay. Khan's not going to disrupt his rhythm. He's trying to find a rhythm. He's trying to disrupt Edward's rhythm. And he's okay.
Folayang looks like he's got a bit of pepper about him here in the second round. Throwing the strikes, got the output, got the work rate. Time for Amir Khan to pick up the pace now. Outside leg kick, missed the target from Folayang. Goes back to center cage, drifts off to his left. Stiff jab there from Khan, that was a beauty.
Like that jab, he's got to do more of that. He can't allow Folayang to start throwing target practice.
Folayang remaining high on the balls of his feet now. Looking very spry. Khan thrust the jab out again. Maybe needs a right roundhouse kick for company after that left jab. Beautiful Wushu kick again there from Folayang. Looks for the inside thigh, goes to the body, picks him up, tries to put him down, but Khan maintains his vertical status.
I'd like to see Khan start going after the legs of Folayang. Start throwing those jabs and then just putting a little bit of a leg kick on, just so if this does go into the later rounds, four or five rounds, that, you know, the movement's not quite so explosive for Folayang, because he can do this for 25 minutes, no problem. Khan's got to slow him down. Go back to the body. He's getting away from his game plan.
The Philippines currently own four world championships at one championship. Can Eduard Folayang make it five out of a possible eight? That would be an incredible national achievement. Switching stance again. Khan just gets out of the way. That wicked left hook of Folayang. It is sharp and fast. Inside leg kick from Folayang. The tension here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. You just get the feeling that at any moment something could happen. Plenty of action from Folayang. Little puppy right hand on the inside. Overhook of that left arm from Amir Khan.
Momentum is starting to shift in Folayang's favor. Now he's got him pressed up against the cage. Khan's got him. See how he attacks him? He presses him up against the cage. So Khan can't separate the hips. He's not able to deliver those knees with the same amount of force because his hips are pressed up against the cage. Watch Folayang get pressed up against the cage.
Oh, spinning back fist! Inside leg kick. Here comes Folayang. Here comes the landslide. And Amir closes him down. Oh, spinning back fist again. It is champagne from Folayang. Sold out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila. third round of five. Wherever you're watching in 138 countries around the world, in particular, all of our fans here in the Philippines on ABS-CBN Sports in Action in Singapore on Octo Sports Toggle. On the edge of your seats, no doubt, cheering on these two tremendous martial arts warriors.
See, this is what happens. Eduard Folayang is starting to get more and more comfortable on his feet. Khan has to change the direction of this match. He's got to shoot him for takedowns. He's got to get Folayang to think about something else besides just the striking, because that is Folayang's world.
Here Khan trying to wind up the roundhouse kick. He's found so much success with it in the past. Third round of five. What is Khan thinking right now? He took some heavy strikes in the second round. A lesser man would have gone down, but not Amir Khan. Folayang tries for the overhand right. Khan taking his time. Tucks the chin, looks through the brow. Folayang skips in for an inside leg kick. Adding side kick to the lead thigh there from Folayang, showing that wushu styling. What should Khan be looking for here, Mitch?
He tried to throw that big overhand right. Folayang saw it coming and was able to get out the way. Khan's got to spin around now, press him up against the cage, try to take him down. He's only just standing there. He's gotten away from his game plan. He's not throwing the body kicks. He's not attacking the legs of Folayang. He's just now going headhunting with the punches. Khan's got to change things up a little bit. Look at this pressure of Folayang driving the head into the chin.
Khan climbs towards his corner, tries to pull the head down for the meet and greet knee. Both men reset, under 3 minutes remaining in the third round. Khan goes high, Folayang goes low. Fakes there from Amir Khan, out of southpaw starts.
He's got to put some combinations together. Right now, he's just one punch, one kick. Folayang can see that stuff coming. You got to set him up.
Folayang, double forearms guard against the left roundhouse kick. This crowd has gone silent on the edge of their seats here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. If Folayang lands again like he did in the second, they will raise the roof. Takedown for the former champion! To the feet goes Khan, trying to lock up a choke attempt. That's out the head for Folayang. My word, Folayang is looking sharp. But there is still a long time to go. Khan has youth on his side.
Nice elbow from the clinch. He was able to connect with that right elbow.
Folayang showing that older age shall not weary him. Khan sets the left roundhouse kick here. Chose to go the rear hand instead. Switches stance now to orthodox as Amir Khan. Is he going to go the right roundhouse kick?
Let's see him attack the leg with that kick.
Stiff jab. Tried to catch Folayang coming in. Folayang fakes up the lead. Got to make sure he keeps his hands up here, Ed Wood. Throw to toe now. Khan switches back to southpaw. Now back to orthodox. Trying to confound Folayang. Trying to mix it up, keep it fresh. Folayang rushes him back against the wire now. Throws a corking knee.
Control. Watch out, Edwards controlling the left hand there of Khan. Khan, good circle out.
Big left hand, oh, and another one! Folayang lands a double left hook.
Khan right there on the right side. You can see that mouse starting to develop under the eye.
The right hand, the high kick, the right hand again! And the crossing elbow! Edward Folayang, more combinations than a Sudoku. What a performance from the former champion! Catches that roundhouse kick and came agonizingly close there for Khan. Out of both men throwing knees on the inside. This is how the round ends.
Eduard Folayang is starting to inch ahead. He found a lot of combinations that found success. Look at this, there was that punch coming. He was able to avoid it, goes right underneath, secures the very aggressive takedown from Khan, but Khan was able to scramble, trying to control with the front headlock, but Folayang was able to get back up to his feet. Again, look at that beautiful duck under, over the top. Left hand, Folayang's mixing in the weapons well. Khan has got to change something he's doing. Right now he's only boxing. He's got to get back to the body kicks. He's got to attack the legs. He's got to mix things up a little bit, at least start to circle off, to create angles, and not just go forward and back. Folayang is really putting things together. He's mixing his kicks extremely well with his punches.
We go into what they call the championship round. The four for five for the lightweight championship of the world. Eduard Folayang, Amir Khan. Youth on the side of Khan. Experience on the side of the former world's champion, Folayang. Khan looks for an early takedown. Folayang stops the attempt. Right in front of our commentary position now. Tandrel against the wire, knee there from Folayang, doubles up on it.
See, that's how good Folayang is in the clinch. Even when he's being pressed up against the cage, he still finds a way to create a little bit of space with his hips and throw those knees. Look at that, three, four unanswered knees, five knees now that have all landed to the body. Even inside the clinch, he's very dangerous with those knees because of those little subtle ways he's able to find that space and land those knees.
Muay Thai style, Amir Khan would love to lock on that Muay Thai clinch. Not going to happen at the moment, though. Oh, spinning back fist, caught him on the orbital. Beautifully done there from Folayang. Turning like a tornado, fires out the left kick.
The third time he's been able to exit and throw a spinning back elbow. Every time he clinches up the cage, he lands the knees, softens up the body, and then Khan starts to drop his hands. Folayang, spinning back elbow. Third time he's done it. Good job by Khan. Now he's starting to threaten the takedowns. But the takedown defense of Folayang is so good. He gets the underhooks, presses Khan up against the cage. Now he's attacking the legs for the takedown his own.
Into the inside thigh from Folayang. Looks for the horizontal elbow.
Look for the elbow. Watch, he's controlling the hand right here. There's one elbow, let's see if he spins. He can't spin because of the underhook on the left side.
Oh, those elbows slicing up. Amir Khan, cut under the right eye of Khan.
See, now he can spin. Now he can spin with the right side. Yep. Chooses to go right up the middle.
Uppercut elbow from Eduard Folayang. It's all coming off the right arm of the Filipino. And another one tries to put the chin through the top of the head. The heavy artillery from Eduard Folayang. Amir's face showing the signs of those punishing Folayang elbows. Wants to sink a choke here on Folayang. Folayang puts the head out. Lands another left hook.
That's the biggest difference, Michael, that I've seen in Eduard Folayang so far is up against the cage. It's that clinch. It's doing damage up against the cage. This is a completely new element from Eduard Folayang. This is not something he's had. The way he's damaging little tiny shots. Oh, big head kick.
That's two high kicks in a row. The game terrifyingly close for Amir Khan. Folayang's got to keep that right glove glued to the side of his face.
That's not his style. He doesn't really protect that head. He likes to relax. He likes to flow. See how that hand keeps drifting down?
Folayang breathing a little heavier now. Fourth round of five. Gets out of the way of that high lift round. Slow down a little, Folayang. Can Amir Khan capitalize? He's got the youth, Khan. Folayang sets the right hand here. Rips off. Wushu kick to the lead leg. Circling into the power side, though, of Amir Khan. Folayang. Quickly drew the shots, just spinning hook kick. The acrobatics from Eduard Folayang. Thought about that side kick downstairs. 1 minute remaining, 4 for 5. Nice catch of the roundhouse kick there from Folayang. Southpaw starts here now on Amir Khan. Now switches back to Orthodox. Folayang, go watch those turnarounds. That's what Martin Nguyen caught him on when he got knocked out last time. Spinning back fist, duck under there from Amir Khan. Looks at the inside leg, just Folayang.
Like, see him shoot for a takedown as Khan's Folayang spinning, but he's doing such a good job at defending the takedown so far. He's got to keep starting kicking again. He's got to attack those legs. Folayang's movement hasn't slowed at all.
Spinning kick, inside thigh kick from Folayang. Was it beauty? Final seconds of the fourth. We're going into the fifth. The deepest of deep water. Amir Khan has never been here before. Eduard Folayang has many times. How will that factor into things? Amir Khan, never been to five.
Let's watch Folayang do work up against that cage. The little subtleties that he's bringing to his game have completely changed. Watch this. He creates a little bit of space there with his hips, right? Boom, lands one knee. Boom, there's another knee. Look how he opens up the arm of Khan and lands those knees. Then he forces the arm down, gets Khan fighting the arm. Boom, comes right up top with a beautiful over the top. There's that spinning heel kick. Changes it up, changes the direction of the foot. So normally you throw the heel up, but then he hit it with the palm of his face. The three champions directly behind us, the strawweight, the bantamweight, and the flyweight world champions want another belt to take home to Baguio. Do they have enough space in their luggage, Michael Schiavello?
Here we go, the fifth and final round. Tension in the air. Philippines claim fifth world champion here at One Championship. Khan comes out of his corner quickly. Throws the high lift round. That's his prime weapon. Shoots him for a double. Sprawl out there from Folayang.
Takedown defense has gotten so much better. Khan's usually been able to take opponents down, but Folayang leveled up.
Wrist control, both men jousting for it. Spinning back elbow from Folayang, then goes down to the thigh. Crossing elbow from Folayang. Overhook on the left arm for Amir Khan. Wants to sink a choke of the Filipino. Folayang defends against it. And they break off. Let's see if Khan gets the roundhouse kick off the right leg here. Folayang's drifting into it. Overhand right from Khan. Will Khan switch back to southpaw stance? There's the high left roundhouse out of southpaw, now back to orthodox. Shoots in, another takedown defense from Folayang. Overhooks the right arm.
Takedowns and takedown defenses score the same, so Folayang is scoring with all these takedown defenses beautifully. It's that cage control we were talking about at the beginning. Folayang takes this match where he wants to. If he wants to keep it on the feet, that's where he does it. If he wants to keep him up against the cage, Folayang keeps him up against the cage. If he wants to keep it in the dead center, he's doing it.
Mitch Amir Khan's mouth open here. Is the younger combatant fatigued in the fifth and final round?
I believe so. Folayang has never gotten tired. Look at him, still throwing the heat with the feet.
You train at those high altitudes in Baguio City. One thing all Team Lakay has is cardio for days.
But not just training at high altitude, it's the work rate that these guys put out. It's constant. They do so much conditioning, so much training. They're such highly refined athletes in every sense of the word.
Nice elbow there from Folayang off the left arm.
Watch the elbow. See how he controls the hand? Boom, he pins down the hand and comes up with the elbow. Look at that.
Slicing and dicing with the elbows on the inside. The former world champion. 2:35 remains, fifth and final.
Those are little shots, but man, they are paying such dividends right now. He's controlling the clinch so well.
Jab to attempt there from Folayang. Khan's got to go, and he's got to go soon. It may be time to throw caution to the wind and pull out all the stops for Amir Khan. Folayang, ooh, that came close, a matter of millimeters. Jab there from Folayang, uppercut from Khan, a right hand from Folayang. Folayang gets out of the way of the jab. Orthodox stance for Khan, who has switched the entire contest. Folayang goes to the outside lead leg. Spinning heel kick! That came close to shin. I should say heel to neck. And that connects. It's good night for Khan. Uppercut from Khan, nicely done. There's a jab from the Singaporean. Is he going to get his second win here with 1:30 remaining?
I think we're looking at his fourth win right now, Michael. He's trying to push forward. He's trying to keep hunting. But look at Folayang going for the takedown. Good defense from Khan, though.
Khan stays vertical. We're moving towards the final minute of this world title bout. Khan glances towards his corner.
Elbow again!
Tried to shave the moustache off. 1 minute now. Are we going down to the judges, or will we see a finish in the final 60 seconds? It has been a champagne performance from Eduard Folayang. But Khan is not done yet. He will not wave the white flag. He will not go quietly into the night.
A side kick! Another one!
Folayang showing the wusha. Dropped out for a single leg, didn't have it. Pitches upstairs. Khan tried to pull the head down. Jab to Folayang, and there's the hook afterwards.
30 seconds left in the
round. Has Khan got a Hail Mary shot in reserve here? Has he got a big time? Oh, flying kick! Eduard Folayang in the dying stages with the acrobatics. Side kicks and the spinning kicks. This one's for the Philippines. This one's for the nosebleeds. Emotional scenes. Standing ovation here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. What a performance from Eduard Folayang to turn on the acrobatics in the final 30 seconds to stuff the takedowns attempts of Amir Khan. Victor Kui to present the championship belt. My word, extraordinary world title match. Sellout crowd inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Millions watching around the world, especially here in the Philippines on ABS-CBN Sports in Action. Is there about to be an outpouring into the streets of Baguio City? Is the party in the high altitude about to begin? Or will Singapore get its first ever homegrown world champion? Let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision.
Spilling over here in Manila. Can you believe it? Can you believe it?
blow, back of the head and spine. I want a clear fair fight. Touch glove if you want, and back your corner.
A moment before a heavyweight title bout. You can cut the atmosphere here in Manila with a chainsaw. It is electric.
All right, just
five rounds, but will it go that far?
Ready, talk.
The time for talk is over. Michael Schiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. That's Mauro Cirilli of Italy. Brandon Vera, defending champion of the Philippines. Vera at 113 kilos. Cirilli at 111 kilos. More beef than a cattle ranch in the cage at the moment. High kick early from Vera. It will be Vera's speed and precision against the raw power of the Italian hammer. And look out for the overhand right on Mauro Cirilli. Vera chops downstairs. Cirilli wants to bridge the gap, get on the inside, and go for the champion's jaw.
Cirilli's trying to close that distance, having a hard time dealing with the range of Vera. But he's got to get on the inside. He can't stay at the end of these kicks.
Vera has the height. He's got the reach. Wants to keep the Italian at bay. Switches to southpaw here. Look out for the high kick off the left leg here from Vera. It's a lead hook. Oh, swinging. Beautiful knockout punches.